What happens when you take your life from the perspective of a daughter left behind? Someone has to find you, and in my case, I was the one who found my mother. That person will be forever haunted with that memory. They will have flashbacks in their dreams for the rest of their lives. It has been almost 10 years for me, and I still wake up hyperventilating because I am being forced to watch my lifeless mother in the trees over and over again. Your loved ones will blame themselves for your decision. We know that you felt there was no other way out of your pain, but we will replay every conversation we had with you leading up to the day that you left. We'll ask ourselves, what if I said something different? What if something I said was the final straw? I should have had more enthusiasm. In my voice. I should have checked in more. The possible scenarios are endless, and they'll spend the rest of their lives blaming themselves and asking those questions. Your friends and family will fall into a depression. Your death may cause a domino effect if they don't get the help they so need. But in their minds, why would they get help if you didn't, or if it didn't work for you? If your friends and family get through the initial pain and shock of your death, you'd think, oh yay, they made it past a year, they'll be okay. You're absolutely wrong. Every time something good happens in their life, they will be filled with sadness all over again, because the one person they want to celebrate those times with isn't there. Feel guilty every time that they are supposed to be happy. Moments that are supposed to be someone's happiest times, graduating high school, falling in love, getting married, having children, will become moments we are anxious about, moments we dread, moments we feel we can't be happy about, because why should we be happy? You obviously didn't love us enough to be here to be happy with us. It's our fault you left us, so why the hell should we be allowed to be happy? Even though a part of us knows that all this isn't true and that we are allowed to be happy, this is what goes through a suicide survivor's mind. The ones you leave behind will search and search for every existing photo and video of you. And when they realize there are no more, they will refuse to believe it and will look through every old email address they've ever known, every old photo editing app they've ever used, every box packed away in hopes of finding just one more, so they don't have to keep posting the same 6 photos every holiday, every birthday. This whole post isn't about guilting you into staying or trying to make you feel bad about wanting to end your life. This post is about making you realize that your thoughts are not being kind to yourself. The ones you're going to be leaving behind as suicide survivors. We won't be better without you. We won't be happier, love life more, or forget about you. We would much rather have you here with all of your dark and all of your light than have to go the rest of our lives without you. Having to tell every new person in your life you lost your mother to suicide. Having to feel like a charity case when you see the light in their eyes leave, as they feel uncomfortable about how to react. Having to feel like everyone looks at you like you're broken. So please stay, I'm begging you. Your loved ones need you. Your friends need you. I need you. The world needs you. If you're at rock bottom right now, the only way left to go is up. And now a message to the suicide survivors listening to this. I refused to accept that it gets better with time, that wounds heal as the years go on, but in a way that cliche saying is right. Although I don't really think it gets easier, you just become stronger and more used to dealing with the pain, and over time it doesn't crush your chest every time you take a breath. Over time, you notice the tears become less as each holiday passes. I don't know if it's because I'm healing, or if I simply don't have any more tears left to cry after these 9 years. Over time, you'll start feeling real happiness again, even though afterwards you'll have suicide survivor guilt episodes that could last days or weeks. The bright side is that you'll still have bursts of genuine happiness that'll help pull you through these episodes. It took me almost 8 years to finally get professional, consistent help. I was so against therapy and medication for many reasons that stemmed from my mother. Once I finally stopped fighting and accepted fully the fact I couldn't get better on my own is when the real healing occurred. I started therapy, got on antidepressants. I focused on myself and started being selfish for my own mental health. I started talking about my traumas and processing them instead of repressing everything like I had been doing all of those years. It hurt like hell. I had a burning sensation in my chest for weeks. My PTSD flashbacks were worse than they ever had been before, and for the first time, I was having them while I was awake. I remember vividly multiple times I would let my dog out and the trees would creak a certain way that made me have visual flashbacks. I saw my mom there dangling from the trees right in front of me all over again. Then the further I dug into therapy and the more I opened up and shared my story with my therapist, the time in between the flashbacks grew longer. I was able to breathe again. I learned how to control my panic attacks. I finally realized how good it felt to get help. This is my message to all of you survivors out there like me. Even if getting help didn't save your loved ones, please, please know that that doesn't mean it can't help you. Don't allow their death to cause a domino effect of loss, pain, and hurt. Be the strength they couldn't grab. Never forget them. Never allow the world to forget them. Share their story and scream their names from the mountaintops. Let them know they were wrong and that people did notice that they left. They were your whole world, and don't ever let anyone make you feel bad for talking about them. If they tell you they are uncomfortable about you sharing your story, kindly remind them you are uncomfortable having had gone through something so traumatic and that you have every right in the world to keep speaking on it. It's your story to tell and nobody can take that away from you. This is the last video in my series, so I'm going to put some help information on the screen for you. Please stay and please get help if you need it. I love you all so much.